Hi guys, hope you are all doing well. So welcome to Elion Digital Process Automation, which is a Pega-oriented real-time training platform. So in today's session, we are going to see about one of the methods in activities. So that method we are going to use very often in the activity logics that we are going to use in the real-time programming. So let us see in today's session about OBJ Open. Okay, so let me share my screen. So OBJ Open. So OBJ Open is one of the method in the activities or activity rules used for the purpose of opening an instance or an object from a relevant class. So the purpose of OBJ open is to open the instance or open the object. So as we know that we already have a lot of records in the class, that means there is a database table which is mapped to that class. So all the records are nothing but the instances in terms of object-oriented terminology. So if you want to open any particular record or if you want to open any particular object from the class or from the table, that is only single record at a time. In that scenarios, you are going to use OBJ open. So the name itself says that OBJ, it's nothing but an object, open. So open the object. So this is the naming convention that which is given for this OBJ open method. So using this method, what we are going to do is we are going to open the instance or we are going to open the object from a specific class which is defined in the parameters. So let us see in the activity rule. So this is the OBJ open method. Okay. So basically, this is the activity rule, as you already know. And so I'll just comment out this. So this is the OBJ open method. So the purpose of method is to perform certain specific operation or specific execution. So the what are the method that you specify over here? So it will execute the relevant execution based on the purpose. So if you want to open the object, you will use OBJ open. If you want to do some other operation, let's say OBJ save or save the object, you will use OBJ save or other methods which are relevant to your requirement. So in my scenario, so we are going to use OBJ open. So OBJ open, if you choose, so you are going to get the following method parameters. So if I choose OBJ open, so here you can see the method parameters. So there are almost 4 to 5 parameters that we need to define. The first parameter is open class. So here what we need to do is we need to specify whatever the class that we want to open the object. Okay, if I have, let's say I have this class personal details. So this is my class. So where I have some records in it. Okay, so these are the relevant records in this particular class or relevant objects, you can also call it as. Okay, so if I want to open any of the class, any of the single object, so I will use OBJ open. Okay, so here I will define whatever the class I want to fetch the object. So I need to define that class. So my class name is, this is my class name. So where I need to copy this. So copy it here. Okay, this is the class name. From which class you want to open the object? So that you need to define here. And then coming to lock. So lock, if you check lock, then what it will do is, whenever Pega opens this object, whenever the Pega opens any object from this particular class, so it will acquire the lock, and it will not allow the other requesters or other users to perform. I mean, it will not allow the other users to perform any operation on this particular object. Let's say if I open this particular object, okay, this particular record I have opened using obj open, and I have checked that obj, sorry, I have checked that lock as true. Okay, so what happens is, so this particular record is locked by the relevant user or relevant requester where this particular activity gets executed. Okay, from which requester that particular activity, this particular activity gets executed. So with that requester, this particular record is locked. So this lock, the lock, I mean, the lock is acquired by the requester. So if other requester or other user tries to access this particular particular record or object, so if they want to update something, they cannot do it. Okay, because this is already locked by the current requester. So there is a bit ambiguity between the two things. The first thing is, I have one requester R1. Okay, so I have one requester R1, means one user, and R2 is the other user. Okay, so if R1 is executing this activity through R1, this login, this activity is executed and this obj open is performed, and obj open, I have opened the instance. Okay, what is the record name? So that person name is so and so Ranjit. I'll just straight away give the values. So this is the Ranjit object which I have opened. Okay, here, and I have acquired the lock for this particular object. So that means I have checked this, I mean, when this activity is executed, so this particular lock is checked, so that this particular requester has the lock for this object, Ranjit object. Now, let's say if R2 is trying to access this object, and if he wants to update something in this object. So in that situation, this R2 requester, means some other requester, cannot update this particular object because this object is already locked with R1. Okay, it is not yet released. So this particular other requester cannot update the information or cannot update any other information as this particular object is locked by R1. So this is the purpose of lock. So as and when this R1 releases the lock, then R2 can access this particular object. So this is what the release on commit. So the release on commit, if you check release on commit, what happens is, whenever the commit operation is done, whenever any update is done to this particular object by R1, let's say R1 updates this Ranjit name as, we already have columns, right? So we have this other number, date of birth, mobile number, age, and all these things, right? So let's say if R1 has updated, R1 requester has updated in the Ranjit record, the age value from 18 to 20. Okay, so once he updates and commits the data, then R2 can access that. Until unless R1 updates the data and releases the lock, R2 cannot access this particular object. So that is the purpose of lock and release on commit. So once the object is locked, so other user cannot access until it is released by the current requester. So this is what the release on commit. So if you check this, so as and when the commit, some database changes has been done, and then this particular requester will release the lock so that other users can access the other time. So this is the purpose of both lock and release on commit. So this is not required. We don't much use in the real-time scenarios. And coming to the property name and property value. So this is the most important. If you don't give and save it, so system will throw a validation that you need to specify the mandatory values. So here the purpose of this particular property name, why it is mandatory is, so if you want to open any object, basically what you need to do is you need to specify the key and a value for that. So if you don't specify a key, you cannot access any instance of that particular class. So let's say if I open this class, so I have a key defined over here. So the key for this particular class, this is the class, right? So this is the class record and this is a key. So if I don't define this key, I cannot access any record, any object I cannot access. I have to pass the key value. Then only I can access the whole record. Here we have four records. So if I don't specify the Aadhaar number, which is a key to this class, so I cannot access the particular record. Okay, so the keys concept is already covered in other sessions of classes. So the importance of key, because to avoid the duplications, so for every class, we'll be having a primary key. Okay, so if you don't define the primary key, obviously we cannot access the particular record because system doesn't know which record it has to pick at the runtime. So if you say open Ranjit record, I want this record, for example. So you can't say that system go and open the Ranjit record. No. You have to specify this Aadhaar number so that it will, based on the Aadhaar number value, it is going to fetch the Ranjit record. Because system has to know. So if you want to access particular, there might be multiple Ranjit records, right? So let's say if I add one more record, I have added one more record as Ranjit. And I have added one more record, let's say. So now, total how many Ranjit records? Three persons are there with the same name. So how do you identify which Ranjit you want? You want this Ranjit or this or what? If there may be 10 or 20 records with the same name, what is the situation? So there is a duplication. The data is not accurate. It's not exact. So these are the issues that will occur in the real time. So that is the purpose of key. So if you have a key, right? So even every record, even every column, okay, may have same values, but the key will be different. It will be unique. So that is the purpose of key. So that is the reason why every class is defined with a key. Every concrete class is defined with a key. So here our key is Aadhaar number. So we need to specify the Aadhaar number. Here on the left side, we need to specify the column. Column name is Aadhaar number. And here we need to specify the value. So which record you want to open? Which record you want to open? Let's say I want to open this person, Ranjit. So I need to specify this value. Then save. So now this completes the OBJ method, OBJ open method. But so before going to this, we need to follow some programming standards, coding standards. So what is that is? So you are trying to open the object using this method, but where you want to open that? Once you open the object, where it will be? So obviously it will be in the temporary memory area or a buffer area, which is called a clipboard. So in the clipboard, you want to display this object or you want to fetch that object and place it in the buffer or clipboard. So you need a page. Okay, you need a page to be defined. So in Pega, as you know, everything is happening only through pages. If you want to save the data, you have to use pages. If you want to update the data, you need to use specify pages and properties. So everything is in terms of pages. So without pages, you can't do anything in Pega. That's what. So in the clipboard, we have to define this page. So you are saying obj open. So open this particular object from this particular class on this particular page. So this is called page name or step page name. Okay. So this is called step page name. So this one you need to define first in the pages and classes. Here, there is a tab called pages and classes. Here you need to define the page name, and the right side you need to define the class name. Okay, so what is this pages? This is user defined. Whatever the page name that you want, you can define anything. It's up to you. And this is the class. So why I define data as personal details is this is my class. Which class means? My object class is this. So I define this class. Okay. So now whatever the object that is open, that will be on the personal info page. So this is OPJ open. So before that, we have one step called page new. So the purpose of page new is, so it is going to create a new empty page in the clipboard. So why we create new empty pages? Let's say if you open this object on this page, next I want to open another object, okay, with other value, other number, other record I want to open. So this page is already having the old record. So there might be causing some overriding issues or, you know, all those things. So instead of facing all those, what we are going to do is we are simply going to define new page. Page new means create a new clipboard page. So what is that page that it is going to create? Personal info. So as and when the first step executes, so in the clipboard, what happens is, so it will simply in the clipboard, so it will simply create a new page in the first step. Okay. And once it creates a new page after execution of this, so this page name is, so basically this will be the clipboard. And this is the page name, personal. I'm just writing in shortcuts. So this is the personal info page. And the object which is open will be on top of this, like what is the name, Ranjit, what is his age, something like 18, and what is his gender, something like male. So the data will be on this particular page. The object data will be on this particular page. So this is the clipboard. And on the clipboard, first, what happens? So page new will create a new empty page. Once the empty page is created, obj open will open the particular instance or object on this particular person info page. So this is the purpose of obj open. And just let us see by executing this particular activity and checking the real time.